Although Tom Clancy's The Division is mostly catered towards groups, I think we often end up playing alone, and often a one-man army is all it takes. So for those that are interested in the solo grinds, we're covering the classified Alpha Bridge build today. Beforehand, Alpha Bridge is, at the moment, not the strongest gear set. If you're looking for more effectivity, you want to look for different builds, like Classified Nomad, Striker or D3 FNC. However, it's not a bad build, and for variety's sake, you might want to give this a try to switch things up. This build will be mostly built towards PvE, however, not PvP. A second note before starting, I designed blueprints of the gear, weapon, skills and talents with all the information you need, and I uploaded those on Patreon. It's for those who are interested in being able to have a look at the build without rewatching the video again. These are one among many rewards for patrons, so if you're willing to support Masterminds HD monetarily, you can find the specifics on Patreon. Most builds specialize in a certain area, like the D3 FNC Ballistic Shield build will in toughness, or the Reclaimer Healer in skill power. However, the classified Alpha Bridge, being a solo build, will be a jack of all trades kind of guy, meaning it has a little bit of DPS, a little bit of toughness, and a little bit of skill power. When we unlock the 6 piece, you will see why. Similar to other builds, we'll equip the classified Alpha Bridge gear set to unlock all bonuses up to the 6 piece. The 2 piece increases health regeneration by 100%, meaning we're back to full health twice as fast compared to a normal agent. This only applies to the health regeneration after you're out of combat and your health starts regenerating again. This isn't during combat, so you have to wait the same amount of time as a normal person would, and then the health regeneration itself is twice as fast. The 3 piece adds 5% weapon damage, and so we see the variety in the way this gear set works. The 4 piece adds the Alpha Bridge talent. If the equipped primary and secondary weapon are of the same weapon category, the player will gain the last talent of the other weapon. Also, the stat requirements for each of the weapon talents are ignored. An important side note to this is that this doesn't apply to exotic weapon talents, so if you're smart, you want to stick to high-end weapons. Since we have the classified Alpha Bridge, we're gaining the 5 and 6 piece bonuses. The 5 piece, which is a combination of the 2 and the 3 piece, increases the health regeneration by another 25% on top of the 100% we already had, and adds 10% weapon damage on top of the 5% we already had. The 6 piece bonus comes with the improved Alpha Bridge talent. The wall of text that is the description can be hard to uncover, but it's fairly easy once you take the time to read it. This talent deactivates any signature skill you have equipped and replaces it with a personal version, a mini signature skill, so to speak. The 3 signature skills rotate every 6 seconds. Upon getting a kill on a player, or veteran or elite NPC, the active signature skill is activated for 10 seconds. So let's say you have a recovery link at the time and you get a kill, during those 6 seconds it's up, you activate it for 10 seconds. The effect these have isn't as strong as it usually is, but is reduced by 25%. However, this only applies if the primary attributes, meaning firearms, stamina and electronics, are balanced. These times are shortened depending on the difference between the player's primary attributes. So let's say you have 10,000 firearms and 2,000-3,000 kill power, it's gonna be a large gap and it's only gonna last 1 second maybe. So keeping these balanced is of importance. A side note to this is that you can't use your signature skill normally, and it won't be influenced by your group member's signature skills. This means that when you're down and a group member wants to use their recovery link on you, it will not work. That's why this build is a little bit better for solo play and not for team play. It's a complicated talent and requires some experience to be effectively used, however it can be strong in the right hands, although it's simply not as strong as Striker, Predator's Mark, D3 FNC or Nomad. But we still have a lot of attributes to talk about. Every piece of gear also has main stats, armor, major and minor attributes, as well as slots for the prototype and performance mods. Specking into the primary attributes is slightly harder than usual, since we don't simply spend all our points in one primary attribute. To put it simple, we're running with around 6,000 firearms, 5,000 stamina and 4,500 electronics. This means you want 2 gear pieces with firearms, 2 with stamina and 1 with electronics. the 6th gear piece, the holster, will automatically roll all of them at the max value. Roll these up to 1401 to maximize their effectiveness. Armor rolls are different for each of the 6 gear pieces as per usual. On screen, the maximum values are showcased. If we optimize our build, this is one of those things we don't have to worry about. The major attributes are the next most important attribute on a gear besides the primary attributes. Keep in mind that we're mostly focusing on PvE. Roll on your gear the following: health, exotic damage resilience, critical hit chance, critical hit damage, and assault rifle damage. On screen you can see specifically how I rolled it on each piece of gear. The minor attributes are a little bit simpler. Using this build for PvE will be selecting damage versus elites first, but other than that we'll have burn resistance, blind death resistance, and ammo capacity. The gear mods we're selecting come in two types, prototype and performance mods. There are 5 prototype mods, 2 of which we're rolling with firearms, 2 of which we should roll with stamina, and 1 will roll with electronics. Roll these up to 267 to optimize this. To get a little bit more damage, we're selecting critical hit chance, 5 times 1% for a total of 5% extra. The performance mods increase the bonuses on the skills. To increase our damage further, we're rolling pulse critical hit chance mod, each rolling 2% for a total of 8% extra critical hit chance. That concludes the largest part of the build, the gear. Let's move on to the weapons. The selection of our primary and secondary weapon is different than usually, because they are the same. We're selecting the lightweight M4 twice. The obvious reason behind this is that the Alpha Bridge 4 piece requires us to equip 2 weapons from the same weapon category. The reason we're specifically choosing the lightweight M4 is because it's all around the best assault rifle for close and medium ranges, with its medium damage, high rate of fire, and manageable recoil. In terms of weapon talents, we're selecting on our primary lightweight M4 competent, destructive, and responsive, with responsive being in the free slot. The secondary we're running with deadly, fierce, and unforgiving, unforgiving being in the free slot. Depending on what weapon you have selected, you will always have responsive or unforgiving active since they are in the third slot. I think we all know the effect of these talents, and they can also be seen on screen, so I'm not gonna explain those any further. Moving on to the mods, we're mostly focusing on critical hit chance and damage rather than headshot damage, which is the normal thing to do, quote unquote. This is because on the gear we've rolled attributes toward critical hit chance, and not focusing on that would be a waste. Usually for assault rifles you would focus on headshot damage. The optic of choice is the Pro Red Dot Sight with its increased critical hit damage. The minor attributes on the mod should be critical hit chance and headshot damage. In the magazine slot we'll equip the extended magazine, naturally. It increases the magazine size by an insane amount and will be a waste not to equip it. And other than that, we're looking for critical hit chance and rate of fire. The underbarrel supports the small grip, which we'll use to increase the critical hit damage, accuracy, and reload speed. The final mod, the muzzle, is the loud vent break. It increases critical hit damage, critical hit chance, and headshot damage as well. Basically, you roll all the mods you want on a submachine gun usually. The sidearm is similar to every classified build I've made, the Golden Rhino, so I'm not gonna go into that much. I like the Golden Rhino because of its exotic weapon talent. The Golden Rhino talent increases the stagger by 200%, and with its high damage and this effect I can crowd control rushers, which can be nice from time to time. The other weapon talent is always Expert, as it's a sidearm, increasing the damage by 100% when the target is lower than 30%. Sometimes, especially maybe with this build, because we don't have that much DPS, it's nice for finishing people off. Its mods are the Reflex Sight with a critical hit chance, critical hit damage, and stability roll, as well as the Small Laser Pointer with the accuracy, critical hit damage, and reload speed rolls. Not very original, I know, but fun nonetheless. And that's the weapons done. Moving on to the skills and the talents. The skills aren't as strong as in skill builds, however, selecting the right ones is important. The primary skill of choice is the Pulse with the Tactical Scanner mod to increase your damage when attacking hostiles. Alternatively, we could go for the Scrambler mod if we would play PvP with this build, this to counter the effect of an enemy pulse. The Master mod, however, remains the same. Threat Detector, as it's called, gives an early warning of nearby hostiles and identifies if the user has been scanned by a hostile pulse. This one is mostly effective in PvP. The secondary skill is the Support Station with the Immunizer mod. The Support Station has overall more reliable healing than the First Aid, plus it immunizes you from status effects. The master mod Discharge applies an overheal when the station is blown up. However, we should keep in mind that with a recent patch, this has changed. The amount of healing we receive upon blowing up the station depends on how long you have been staying in its range. The longer we've been in it, the larger its healing effect, so you can't just throw it down, pop it, and get an instant boost. Or at least you can get a very small one. The signature skill you select doesn't matter, because we won't be able to use it anyway. Talents increase this build's effectiveness in a smaller but nonetheless important way. We're selecting Critical Save, Strike Back, On the Move, and Precision. Critical Save is the talent everyone equips. This one you should know by now. It decreases incoming damage by 20% for 10 seconds upon using a medkit at low health. And this one is important if you want to be a bit more self-sustaining, although it won't save you. It just reduces the pain a little bit. Strike Back, a talent not seen so often, reduces skill cooldowns by 20% upon reaching low health. Low health meaning only having one bar of health or less. On the Move reduces incoming damage by 15% for 10 seconds when killing a hostile while moving. With this gear set, we won't be using cover that much, so we will be moving, which makes this talent a must. And finally, Precision pulses a hostile for 10 seconds after headshotting them. And that's all for Bridge for you. In comparison to other gear sets, it might seem a bit underwhelming, and while it's definitely not top tier, it's definitely a build that's fun to try if you're running solo. I don't recommend using this build in PvP or in groups, because it's outclassed in every way by other gear sets. Unless you want to challenge yourself, you don't want to do it. That's it. I appreciate you taking time out of your day to watch this content. If you made it this far, consider leaving a rating, good or bad. It provides feedback and helps showing up in the YouTube algorithm. Comment down below with your suggestions on how you would build your classified Alpha Bridge. Before ending the video, here's a quick reminder. For those interested in being able to have a look at the build without rewatching the video, I designed blueprints of the gear, weapon skills and talents. These are available on Patreon, among other rewards for those who are willing to support us monetarily. The specifics can be found on Patreon. And that is what brings us to the end of this video. That'll do it, have a good day, enjoy some Division gameplay, and peace out.